Hi, welcome to Nona's Here. I'm Nona. If you've been here before, welcome back. If this is your first time here, welcome. I'm so glad you decided to join us today. Today is a subscription box unboxing. I'm back from vacation, had a fabulous time, didn't get a lot of sleep, so those bags are well earned. We were in Las Vegas for 5 days, 4 nights, had a great time, had 2 wonderful, really lovely dinners to make up for all the anniversary dinners, birthday dinners, all those things that we couldn't do over the last year and a half, having to be in lockdown for the virus. Was really wonderful. We had a great time. I left all my money there to pick up the next time we go back. Just had a great time. It was really wonderful to get away. Grumpy Grandpa wasn't grumpy. We just had a great time. But it's always good to be home and sleep in your own bed again. And I had my Walmart and Ipsy bag waiting for me. I had an email from BoxyCharm. Obviously, some of their people went on vacation too, and it's going to be delayed in processing. So who knows when it'll come in. They said the label's been made and that the shipping should be done pretty soon. But I can tell you last month, my BoxyCharm spent a week in Georgia on vacation. So I don't know. Whenever it comes, I'll let you know. So the first thing I got is my Walmart. And this is a seasonal box. The box is free, but it costs $6.98 for shipping. Okay. So usually it's deluxe samples with one full-size product. All right, so let's see what's in here. This is what it looks like when I open it up. And the first thing is, I don't know, because I got to put on my glasses. Can't see a thing. The flights from Pensacola to Houston were relatively empty, but the flights from Houston to Vegas and Vegas back to Houston were totally full. Had to wear a mask on the airplane, but in Vegas, you didn't have to wear a mask anywhere as long as you were fully vaccinated, which Grumpy Grandpa and I were both fully vaccinated. Okay, summer edit, just an advertisement, brochure. First thing I see, Cetaphil Sheer Mineral Sunscreen. Okay, that's just another advertisement. Pencil, ColorStay Eyeliner Pencil by Revlon in black. Okay, that's all right. And I'm gonna say, this is probably a full size. This is a full size, yes. Yeah, that's a full size. Okay, then I got Revolutionary Way to Get a Whole Mouth Clean and Fresh Feeling Anytime. Listerine Ready Tablets, 8 tablets. Okay, wish I would have had these last week. It would have been nice. You just pop them in your mouth and it's like brushing your teeth or using mouthwash. All right, that's okay. Then I got Cetaphil Extra Gentle Daily Scrub. I really like this brand. In fact, before we went on vacation, I went to CVS and I got this brand in a foaming face wash and a hydration moisturizing lotion, facial moisturizing lotion in just the small bottles. You know, they're so expensive, but everything I have is in big tubes, you know, and I didn't want to take that. So I bought the small bottles, and since I like this brand, I got it all in this brand. And, you know, you really need the, I'm going to sneeze. Okay. I think I'm done sneezing. You really need the moisturizing lotion, both body and face. I just got the face in this lotion because the hotels give you the body lotion. But the average temperature when we were in Vegas, the average daily temperature was 115 degrees. So when you walked outside, it was like walking into a blast forest, furnace. It was so hot. Yeah, it was dry, but it was so hot. And so every night and morning, I did my full cleansing routine and I just slathered on the moisturizing lotion on my face. And I didn't have any problems with my face drying out. My lips, on the other hand, were another story because I did not take, like a ninny, I didn't take my lip balm, which I should have. And you really need it. And even though, you know, you drink lots and lots of water, your lips get really dry. And I did try and drink water in between the gin and tonics and Bloody Marys, but my lips did get really dry. But this is really good. And I have just put aside the miniature, the travel size lotion and cleanser for when we travel again. Cause you know, I've got enough stuff here, but at home, but I use that and I'll put this aside for travel too. But I do like this this brand, the Extra Gentle Daily Scrub. I don't have that, but I'll put it in my travel kit. But it was really, really hot in Vegas. But one thing I'll tell you that's a pro, put on your makeup in the morning. Unlike in Pensacola or Florida, when you walk outside, your makeup melts off in 5 minutes. Not in Vegas. You put that makeup on and at 10 o'clock at night, not that I went to bed that early, but at 10 o'clock at night, your makeup is still on. It does not budge in 115 degree weather because you don't sweat. There's no humidity. Oh, here's another one. Sheer Mineral Sunscreen 50 by the same brand. That's good. I like that. Now, these are just samples, but that's okay. Now, here's another one that I like. John Frieda Frizz Ease Dream Curls. Grandpa really likes anything that's frizzies because right now he's growing his hair out because he's going to donate it to for Locks of Love in honor of our new granddaughter. She does not have cancer. He's just doing it in her honor. He's done it once before. But let me tell you, men do not know how to take care of long hair. Okay, because they've never done it before. So he doesn't know how, after he washes his hair, how to wrap it in a turban. He can't put it in a ponytail. He doesn't know how to wrap a rubber band, you know, a covered band around it to make a ponytail. He doesn't know how to do any of that girly stuff that we all grew up doing with long hair. So I have to help him with everything. He also doesn't know how to rinse his hair out real well because his hair is all white and he uses purple shampoo and purple conditioner. And half the time he comes out and his hair is all purple because he hasn't rinsed it out real well. So anyway, but he'll like this, Frizzies, Dream Curls, and John Frieda is supposed to be a good brand. So he'll be happy. I have frizz stuff that he uses too. And the last thing I got is Live Happy Almé. Oh, it's a lipstick. Flip Vibes. And I can look inside, which I don't think you've... Oh, yeah, you can see it. See, it's that orangey color. I kind of like it. It's the color of the tip here. Live Happy is the name of it. Okay, that's a pretty good box. The Frizz Ease hair stuff, the lipstick, the Listerine tablets, mouthwash, and the black eye pencil, and the Cetaphil daily scrub and sunscreen samples. Heck, that's worth $6.98, because I'd say the lipstick is a full size. This isn't a full size, but it's a deluxe sample. So I think that, geez, that's a good Walmart box. Okay, let's look and see what Ipsy gave me. I've opened you know, you get it in this pretty pink package. And I've torn open the package and it says, Discover Yourself, Ipsy. Can you see that? Am I showing it to you? Discover Yourself, Ipsy. And I pull it out. And this is the bag. Nope, that's the back side. This is the bag. Love, have fun. Mascara brush, yes. OMG. Yeah, lips, a happy face doesn't really do anything for me. The bag's kinda, it's all right. I think the bags are kinda cheapy now. Although I much prefer the bags than the plastic cosmetic cases they gave you, because you at least get a lot in the bag. Okay, so what's the first thing I pull out here? It's a little cattywampus. Oh, yes. This is, oh, I was going to look this word up. I don't know what it is. Aloe propolis soothing gel. You know, I don't remember picking anything for this month, so this may be my fault. I may have just missed the choice opening, okay? So aloe propolis soothing gel by Benton. 100 milliliters, $19. Aloe and propolis. I don't know what propolis is. Man, this box is really kind of bent up, I guess because it was in that bag and it's quite a big thing. All right. So it looks like this. I don't know, I'm not gonna squirt any out because I don't need it right now. Now, this doesn't really excite, oh, everything's written in the back. Oh no, there is some English in the back. And just a little bit for external use only. Let's see what I have in my notes. Hydration, no fragrance, and no dyes. Now let me tell you, I like aloe is good hydration, but I have one that's from Dollar Tree that's aloe and cucumber that I really like. And aloe is nice, and aloe usually has a fragrance, okay? And I find that when you put aloe on, afterwards it's sticky. And I pat it in to make sure I get the full effect of the hydration. And the stickiness eventually goes away. And my one from Dollar Tree does have a fragrance, but I like it, but it dissipates quickly. I just don't see that this would be worth, what did I say, $19? Yeah, $19. When you can get aloe a lot cheaper, a big thing of aloe for a lot less than $19. So I think this is overpriced, although I don't know what that propolis is. Aloe is a good product to use, especially if you get sunburned, but you don't have to pay $19 for it, okay? So this is an eh to me, but we'll take it. All right, what's the next thing? Next thing is Girlactic Perfect Pair Eyeliner Duo. Okay, this is duo meaning two, and what this is one of them is a gel pencil, and I like gel pencils, and it's in brown, and I don't have a brown eyeliner pencil, and I think sometimes brown is less harsh than a black eyeliner pencil. Now, most people use a gel eyeliner pencil for the bottom. I don't put eyeliner pencil on the bottom because I end up looking like I have a black eye. So I don't do that. But I do eyeliner on the top lid. And I like an eyeliner gel pencil better than I like a marker felt marker pen. I can use a felt marker pen, but a felt marker pen is more difficult. I can do it, but usually people who do the felt marker pen also like to do a cat eye. And I don't do a cat eye. That is what the felt marker pen looks like. And it does make a nice line. You can get it pretty thin probably. Let's see. Yeah, you can do a nice thin line, very thin line, actually, that top one. So I like this. This is okay. And I'm glad it's in brown because usually they give you nothing but black, 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 black. And I just think sometimes brown is a nice change. I just don't think it's as harsh as the black sometimes is. Okay, hold on. Okay, the next thing I pulled out is Maplin Eye Cream. Now, this is a really small tube, but it is full size. It's 0.5 ounce, $39, and that's about right for an eye cream because with eye cream, you just use a teeny, teeny, tiny bit. It has vitamin C and quinoa extract to hydrate, repair, protect skin, brighten, reduce sunspots. It's vegan and cruelty-free. Now, I just gave Grumpy Grandpa my last new eye cream, which was Dr. Brandt, which I really like. But he had used up all the other eye cream I had given him, and he needs to use eye cream. Okay, it's got a seal. Let me see if I can get the seal off. I don't know, sometimes these safety seals. Hold on, I'm gonna use my cutter to get this off. All right, my cutter and my teeth. Don't do that at home. I hope I didn't smear my makeup. All right, so I got it open a little bit because I wanted to show you. Jeez, oh man, I don't think they want you to use this stuff. Let's see if I can get a little bit out. Yes, I can. I wanted to show you how you're really supposed to put on eye cream, okay? Unless it says 360, you shouldn't put eye cream on your lids, all right? It should only go underneath your eyes. But a lot of people think they should only put eye cream underneath here, and that's not true. You should put eye cream underneath there, but you should take it down all the way down here, and you should put it out here, because this is where you're gonna get crow's feet. Yes, crow's feet. So when I put on eye cream, ring finger, because it's the least strong or the weakest finger, I'm gonna put it and I'm gonna take it all the way down here and gently take it out there and then out there, all the way down here, underneath my eye, and out to there. And then I'm gonna gently pat it in so it's absorbed. Like that. Now, of course, I've got makeup on, so I do this when I don't have makeup on. Before my makeup and at night. But be sure and get down here because the wrinkles are down there too. And that, I mean, this isn't gonna take my wrinkles away, but if you don't have wrinkles, you wanna avoid wrinkles. So that's where you put on eye cream, not just underneath the eyes, but all the way down there, okay? And not on the lids unless it says 360 or the directions say you can put it on your lids. Because you will irritate your lids if you put it on your lids, okay? And this to me has a fragrance. I don't know, but it does to me, and my smeller's not real good. So if it has a fragrance to me, and I don't have anything else on my hands, if it does to me, it might have a fragrance to you. All right, next is C. That's the brand name, I think. C. Tarte. C. Hydrosealer in light medium honey. 6 grams for $25. Yeah, I told you the concealer was the eye cream was $39. Eye cream's real expensive. And you get just a little bit, but you just need a little tiny bit. Okay, this is Tarte. Good brand name, Tarte. Okay. Ooh, it comes in a pretty package. C, I guess that's the color. All right. Twist off. A plush foam. Let's see how it looks for a color. Dark, very dark for an under eye concealer. Probably, I don't know whether you can even see that right there. Great for a hand concealer, but under eye concealer, probably a little too dark. But if you have a concealer and it's too dark for your under eye, it is not a total loss. Use it for a concealer on other parts of your face. If you have dark spots, or you know, you've got acne, or you've got some other facial flaws, which we all have. There's no one with the perfect complexion, all right? If you see someone with the perfect complexion in a picture, that their photo has been photoshopped, okay? Or you can, on a no makeup day, use this as a foundation, okay? Just, you know, dot it around. And if you use a brush or a sponge, this is great as for a no makeup day that you're just gonna use a real light coverage. So don't throw it out. Hydro concealer. And it says vegan and cruelty free. And, you know, I may not use this as an under eye concealer, certainly, but I would use it for a concealer around my face, or I would use it for a no makeup day, just to use it as a foundation. So if you pick up a concealer and it's too dark, you can use it other ways. It's not a total waste. All right, and the last thing is, oh, wait a minute, there's another card in here. Gift your friends. Okay, that's just another advertisement. And this is, it's pretty, Hanalei Sugar Lip Scrub. I love lip scrubs. And of course, it is completely sealed with one of those cellophane wraps. Now, I have a friend who shall remain, nameless. But Sally has very dry lips. And she carries around a lot of chapstick type things. Burt's Bees, I think, is her favorite, because I just gave her one that I think I got in a Walmart box. So she has one in every pocket and every purse, and then she has like 8 or 10 sitting around the house because she's always putting it on her lips because her lips are real dry. But she is only doing 50% of what she needs to do. So Sally, are you listening? Because if you have really dry lips, what you need to do first is a sugar scrub. Now, I know you're not going to run and do a sugar scrub every time before you apply your lip balm. But you should do this once in the morning and once at night. And I do. but I didn't in Vegas. But now that I'm home, I do this. And I have one sitting by my bathroom sink, and I do it in the morning and I do it at night. And I mean, the con to this is if you don't have a little plastic thing, you got to stick your fingers in it, but you're the only one using it, so stick your fingers in. You just take a pinch, rub it right over your lips, and then you can use either a wet or dry washcloth and take it off, and then you put on your lip balm, okay? Just a little pinch of the sugar scrub, rub it around, wet or dry washcloth, take it off, and then put your lip balm on. Then you've really treated your dry lips. If all you're doing is putting the lip balm on, you're only doing half of it, okay? If you're only doing the lip scrub, you're only doing half of it. So first the lip scrub, then the balm. Now, you say, yeah, but I don't have a balm. Yeah, but I bet you've got a lipstick that is a balm. And you don't want to put lipstick on. Oh, sugar, I put this lid on wrong. You don't want to put lipstick on before you go to bed, but you probably have a clear balm that you can put on. Or you can buy one of those, you know, almost everybody has one of those little chapstick thingies. But you need to exfoliate first. I was gonna smell this. Exfoliate first and then do your lip balm. And that will really help keep your lips. That's really doing, well, now I can't get the thing off. There we go. Oh, it smells good. It smells like Hawaii. What can I tell you? All right. So that is what I got in my Ipsy. So let's review. The sugar scrub, Sally, you need to sugar scrub. Okay. The Tarte concealer. The Maplin eye cream, which I need. That's good because grumpy grandpa took mine. The what's the name of this Galactic brown eyeliner. That's a good one. And the Aloe Propolis Soothing Gel, which is an eh. The bag, which is an eh. Is that everything? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, that's 5. Okay, so for this, I pay $25 free shipping plus tax. I'll put my link down below if you're interested. This is the Glam Bag Plus. Next month is my Glam Bag X. That's the Big Daddy for $55. If you want to use my link, it isn't more expensive. It isn't less expensive. I just get referral points, which is nice because then I can order add-ons. Okay. I forgot to tell you how much that sugar scrub is. Sugar scrub is $25. And so the total for everything in my Ipsy bag is, drum roll please, $147. That's pretty good for a $25 box. That's good. So what was my favorite thing? And since I didn't pick anything, what was my favorite thing out of all of these? The eye cream. Yeah, the eye cream, because I can really use that. What was my least favorite thing is the aloe gel, because you shouldn't pay $19 for aloe gel. What would I give this out of 5? Let's see, I liked everything except for the aloe. Geez, I'd give it a 4 out of 5. I didn't think I would like it that much, but I think it's a pretty good bag for $25, $147. I couldn't buy much with $25 in this kind of thing. And I got, let's see, two makeup things, the eyeliner and the concealer. And I got two skincare things, the eye cream and the lip scrub, and one things was the aloe, which I guess you'd call that skincare. So that's pretty good, right? Well, I hope you enjoyed our unboxing. Stay tuned for the BoxyCharm unboxing as soon as it arrives, but don't hold your breath because it may take another week or two. I'm so glad to be home. I am happy to sleep in my own bed, and I hope to see you all again very soon. Remember, I post on Tuesdays and Saturdays, but I can tell you my Saturday video is going to be on Sunday because I am joining an open invite, which you won't want to miss. And please, if you enjoy my video, please give me a thumbs up. It really does help me with YouTube, and I would love it if you would give me a thumbs up, which is a like, a comment, and a share. That really does help me. And remember, be kind to everyone, because there's a lot of crazies out there, and some of them are in Vegas. Talk to you later.